Hi all, we are back with yet another poem, which is As a Man Approaches 30, He May by R. Parthasarathy. You can see that this particular poem is from a huge line or a huge poem which is named as Exile. Okay, so this part which we are going to learn is a very important one as in terms of diaspora. Okay, so here when you read about R. Parthasarathy, he is also known as Rajagopalan Parthasarathy, who was born in 1934 and is an Indian poet, translator, critic as well as an editor. His works include poetry from Leeds in 1968, Rough Passage, which was published by Oxford University Press in 1977, and a long poem with a preface, a book where all poems form part of a single poem, as it were, by R. Parthasarathy, and 10 20th century Indian poets edited by him and published by Oxford University Press in 1976. So his poem, a long poem that involves his poem, the specific one that is Exile, from which our lines are being taken. He translates from Tamil to English also, and his translation into the modern English verse of the 5th century Tamil epic, The Tale of the Anglet, an epic of South India, was published by Columbia University Press in 1993, which received the Sahitya Academy Translation Prize in 1995 and the Association of Asian Studies, Inc. A.K. Ramanujan Booker Prize for translation was given to him in the year 1996. Now coming to our poem, there is a cultural conflict in this particular poem, in which he says that in exile, that means he was born in Tamil Nadu, yet he went to UK and Leeds in order to do his studies. And in 1947, he was granted a PhD. Okay, and you can see that there was a cultural conflict in many of his writings, and this particular writing, The Exile, holds most of his cultural conflict. So, as a young student, he was infatuated with the English language and the way in which the English culture was there. But as he grew closer to this English language and culture, he began to understand that he was of the Tamil origin and his roots are trying to bring him back to Tamil Nadu. Okay. Now, as a man approaches 30, he may take stock of himself. He may try to understand how he had lived before, and he may try to understand what has been stagged or stopped within him. Not that anything important happens. Onnum sambhavichillengilum, that means nothing important, even if nothing important has been happened, yet he must understand what and how he had lived this far. At 30, the mud will have settled. Till 30, we'll be always cramping for the jobs. We'll be trying to settle down in life, marriage, etc. And this mud might have settled at 30. You see yourself in a mirror, because in the mirror, in the childhood, you had always acted in front of the mirror for somebody whom you had admired. And now today, you can see yourself in a particular position. Perhaps refuse the image as yours. Perhaps you may be refusing that image as not yours, because maybe that image may be more older than you might have imagined. It makes no difference unless you overtake yourself, pause for breath, time gave you distance, you see little less. Because This image was seldom seen during the times in which these people or you had always been in trouble searching for a job. You didn't have time to look into the mirror. And when you came back to the mirror, pausing for a breath, you paused for an interval and you came back to the mirror, you see yourself and you see that the person inside the mirror is not the same you, because time had gone away. You stir and the mirror dissolves. You move and the mirror dissolves. The mirror is also dissolving. Experience doesn't always make for knowledge. You make the same mistakes. Experience, even if you experience the same thing again and again, you tend to do or you tend to make the same mistakes again and again. Do the same things over again. The woman you may have loved, you never married. Maybe you had a crush, you had a jilted lover, somebody might have left you. The person whom you had loved may have married somebody else. You might have not married that particular person. These many years, you warmed yourself at her hands. These many years, you were in your lover's hands. And the luminous pebbles of her body stayed your feet, else you had overflowed. So there were so many pebbles in your feet. Otherwise, you might have overflowed with love. Okay, overflowed with the pebbles in the feet means pebbles of her body stayed your feet means the pebbles over the body stayed your feet means she was full of love and your fulfilling desire was always overflowing and but still you kept control of it. So here there is a change of tone, because here you can understand that the lover is not the persona, or the lover is not a person as such. The lover is England. Okay, the person has gone to England. He was in love with England and he didn't marry her, means he is not in love with her and he has come back to his home country. You warmed yourself at her hands. You had find solace. You find your life in the hands of England. The luminous pebbles of her body, the luminous pebbles of the River Thames, the London Bridge in the thaale kuda flow cheyina Thames nadiyada silver pebbles allengi oru pena luminous aitla light emitting pebbles. These pebbles over the body of England stayed at your feet. Your feet was always immersed in that particular pebbles. Else you had overflowed the banks, never reached shore. Always there was a lot of desire, there was a lot of temptation for this particular country or temptation for this particular lover, but that love did not reach the shore. The sides of the river swell with the least pressure of the toes. The brimming or the overflowing of the river wasn't possible because only just 2 feet were present there. Only this person was standing there. If there was a huge number of people there, and you can understand the basics of physics. Right? ഒരു വെയ്റ്റ് ഇട്ട് കഴിയുമ്പോൾ ആ വെയ്റ്റിന് അത്രയും വാട്ടർ ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ് ആവൂലേ. ദ സെയിം വേ ഹിയർ ഓൾസോ ദ ഇമോഷൻസ് ആർ നോട്ട് ഓവർഫ്ലോയിങ് ബിക്കോസ് ദർ ഇസ് ഓൺലി ദ ഫീറ്റ് ദർ, ദ ഹോൾ ബോഡി ഇസ് നോട്ട് ദർ ആൻഡ് ദെയർഫോർ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് നോട്ട് ഓവർഫ്ലോയിങ്. ഓൾ നൈറ്റ് യുവർ ഹാൻഡ് ഹാസ് റെസ്റ്റഡ് ഓൺ ഹർ ലെഫ്റ്റ് ബ്രസ്റ്റ്. ഓൾ നൈറ്റ് ഇൻ ദ നൈറ്റ് യുവർ ഹാൻഡ് ഹാഡ് റെസ്റ്റഡ് ഓൺ ഹർ ലെഫ്റ്റ് ബ്രസ്റ്റ്. വൈ ദ ലെഫ്റ്റ് ബ്രസ്റ്റ്? ലെഫ്റ്റ് ബ്രസ്റ്റ് ഇൻക്ലൂഡ്സ് ദ ഹാർട്ട്. ഹാർട്ടുള്ള വശമാണ് ലെഫ്റ്റ് സൈഡ്. അപ്പം ഹാർട്ടിൻ്റെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ആ ഒരു സിറ്റിയുടെ വൈബ്, ദ വൈബ് ഓഫ് ദ സിറ്റി വാസ് പ്രസൻറ്റ് അറ്റ് നൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് യു ഹാഡ് ഓൾവേസ് ട്രൈഡ് ടു എൻജോയ് ഇറ്റ്. ഇൻ ദ മോർണിംഗ് വെൻ ഷീ ഈസ് ഗോൺ, യു വിൽ ബി അലോൺ ലൈക്ക് ദ സ്റ്റോൺ ബെഞ്ചസ്. in the morning the night la vibe night la partying ellam kamari everything will be calm and there will be just stone benches there in the park and would have forgotten her whispers in the noises of the city. The noise and din of the city at night is gone, it has vanished, and there is some kind of a peace. Okay, so here Parthasarathy is telling about his own life and how he wants to come back to his nation or his home country. The roots are pulling him, and that is why he has come to his home country. Although he had this particular love for the Anglophone literature, Anglophone culture, and he was very much interested in the English language, yet you can see that the love did not ebb and flow for this particular nation. He always found solace in his own home country. So here the England is being compared to a lover. So that is a very good poem, and here we end this, and we can see in the next class. Thank you.